Welcome to iLectureOnline. Remember the first video in the series where we showed that one of the conditions for a hyperbola was that the line drawn from one of the foci to a point on the hyperbola and a line from the other foci to that same point on the hyperbola, that the difference between the length of those lines or the absolute value of the difference between those lines always equals a constant. Yes, the same constant. And so that's what we're saying here, that d1 minus d2 equals a constant, where d1 is the distance from this focus to that point on the hyperbola and from this focus to that point on the hyperbola. And notice that we placed the two foci, one at plus c and the other one at negative c. And there's indeed a relationship between a, b, and c. It turns out that a square plus b square equals c square, or c, the distance to the focus, c is equal to the square root of a square plus b square. So if you know the equation, for example, here's an example of an equation with which very closely resembles that particular hyperbola. If you want to find out the location of where c and minus c is, you can do that using this equation. So c is going to be equal to the square root of a squared. Now a squared is going to be 4 squared plus b squared, which is 3 squared. So this is equal to the square root of 16 plus 9, or the square root of 25, which is equal to, of course, plus or minus 5. Well, got to be careful. So plus or minus c, of course, it'll be the positive value, and the negative value is going to be the plus or minus of the square root of 25, because we do have a plus c and a minus c if we want to be kind of exact about it. But that is how you find the distance from the origin to either one of the foci. It's either 5 units to the right or 5 units to the left from the origin, and this is how we find that. Again, now we have kind of a conclusion in that we understand the meaning of A, the meaning of B, and the meaning of C, and the relationship between those three constants that define, in a sense, a hyperbola. Again, the condition here is that the hyperbola has to have the center at the origin, because if it's not at the origin, we'll show you how that then changes things by offsetting the center to a new location, and then everything will be around that new location, but we'll show you how to do that on the next video.
The focus, they also determine the shape of the hyperbola, right?
Yes, if the focus is closer in versus farther out, it'll shape the hyperbola different, that's right. Yeah, if the two foci are very close together, then the difference in the distance will be very small. If they're far apart, then the difference between the distance is very large. And so it will change the shape of the hyperbola. We probably should do a video on that as well. That's actually a really good point.
I'm full of those.
Yes, you are.